Good evening. Here you see a relay that is designed to be used for mains currents. An important aspect for my home insurance company is that when this lid is closed, this mains switched widget is approved by the European authorities. Here it drives a food mixer. The mains current is switched on and off with this relay and transistor that are connected to the GPIO1 pin of an ESP01 module. The ESP01 module here gets its energy from a coin battery. Here you see the same ESP01 module controlling a flow of liquid in a pipe. There is no pump or other motor here. Gravity is the only force that moves the liquid downwards. Always, when this solenoid valve gets energy from a battery, the valve lets the liquid to flow from the bottle down to the pot. This black MOSFET transistor controls the connection between the 9-volt battery and the solenoid valve. The MOSFET transistor is in turn controlled by an ESP01 module that is blinking its GPIO1 pin. And back there you see an RF socket. Normally people control these sockets with remote controllers, but we of course want to use ESP8266 microcontrollers with RF modules for controlling mains currents. You will find many good YouTube videos on how to use transistors, relays and RF sockets with Arduinos and ESP01 modules. Here I just wanted to remind you of these three fine methods. This development kit and this adapter are from our previous video. With them even an ESP01 module is stable and easy to use. This development kit is even better. It has female pin headers, soldered connections, and this has been the most reliable ESP01 module that I have ever had. Let's connect it to the development kit. Share the common ground with the rest of the system. Connect GPIO0 and GPIO2. And you see that I have already a blink program here. The information goes also to this green LED and both LEDs blink simultaneously. And in the following example, the information goes solely through these two wires, and anyhow we can control such an amount of devices simultaneously. Let's see how it can be done.
With the two wires, we make a so-called inter-integrated circuit or I2C bus. This is a serial communication bus that is easy to use with a ready-made library. First, you tell that this time you want to use the GPIO0 and GPIO2 pins for our I2C bus. All the devices that are on the line of the bus have a unique address. This PCA9685 chip that we use today has the hexadecimal address 40. We always begin a transmission by calling an address. After that, we write a name of some of the registers of the PCA9685 chip. Then we put some value to that register. And then we end those small transmission sessions. These four lines are one way to indicate to the PCA9685 chip that the so-called duty cycle of the pin number 2 should be high for 100% of the time. We will continue like that for 1 second. And these four lines indicate that the duty cycles of the pin number 2 should be high for 0% of the time. In other words, it should be low. We repeat these commands over and over again, and that's why the LED blinks. So you can control the registers and function of this PCA9685 chip with different libraries and with this kind of programs. Let's upload a new program. Here, the duty cycle increases from 0% to 100%. And as the duty cycle gets longer, the LED gets more energy, and our eye senses that the LED gets brighter. The program is simple if you use an Adafruit PWM servo driver library. But don't get this library from Arduino IDE's Manage Libraries service, because their version of this library is much too old. Instead, Google for GitHub Adafruit Servo, download, unzip and add this newest version of the Adafruit library to the folder where your other Arduino IDE libraries are. Restart the Arduino IDE, choose File, Examples, Adafruit PWM Servo Driver, PWM Test, change these pins to 14 to GPIO 0 and GPIO 2 pins that we are going to use, and you could already now run the program. But let me anyhow first clean up this example program for you so that it is more illustrative. We use our two libraries, we communicate with the library through an object for which we give a name PWM, we decide the frequency that we use for the pulse width modulation, and we start to control the duty cycles of the signal. If I change the frequency to about 60 Hz and select a pin that has a servo motor on it, we see that this kind of a program already can somehow control servo motors. In servo motors, the shaft positions are controlled by pulse width modulated signals, where the duty cycles vary from about 5% to about 15%. So, here we have a program that makes that kind of signals. 5% of this 4096 is about 200, and respectively 15% of it is about 600. And we see that now the servo motor moves in a much more predictable way. With the PCA9685 chips, the frequency of the output signal can be changed from about 25 Hz to about 1500 Hz. In our next example, we changed the frequency and get this passive buzzer to play music. Here, the duty cycles remain at 50% all the time. But our program tells the PCA9685 chip to play some frequencies that vary from 261 Hz to 523 Hz. Servos get their energy from an external power source. Inside the box there is an amplifying circuit there, so we don't need to amplify the controlling signal for servos. But if we take a motor driver and do amplify the signals from the pins number 3, 4, 5 and 6, we are able to control this stepper motor. With bigger motor drivers, we can control bigger stepper motors. The amplifying circuit that is in these motor drivers is called an H-bridge. And with H-bridges you can also drive DC motors with different speeds and to the both directions. Of course, you can also amplify digital signals with transistors for some relays, for instance, and by that way switch devices on and off. Or you can amplify a signal with a MOSFET transistor and use the pulse width modulation here as well. By using only two GPIO pins of an ESP01 module, we could here easily control a big variety of devices. And if you need, you can add other PCA9685 chips to this same I2C bus. And just like that, you could get 1024 pulse width modulated digital output pins by using only two GPIO pins of an ESP8266 microcontroller. Just imagine that amount of devices around one single ESP01 module. When I do prototyping with ESP8266 microcontrollers, I like to use this NodeMCU version 2 development kit. Let's connect its GPIO4 and GPIO5 pins to a PCA9685 chip, add a pair of these motor drivers, and do the connections according to this schematic. We use 3.3 volt power supply for the chips and 5 volts for the pulse width modulated signals and for our motors. This white wire comes directly from the GPIO 10 pin and it will control a servo motor. This stepper motor and this DC motor are controlled by our new red motor drivers and through the I2C bus. Now choose Sketch, Include Library, Manage Libraries, search for V2 and install this Adafruit Motorsheet V2 library. Next, choose File, Example, Adafruit Motorshield V2 Library, Motor Party. We must tell to this example program that the address of our PCA9685 chip is still the same for 0. Run the program and see how the three motors run simultaneously. So, we used here the schematic of this excellent Adafruit shield that people usually use with their Arduino Uno. These shields seem also to work at 3.3 volt logic levels, and we of course want to use a NodeMCU. The motor shields already are at the default address 60, so here we don't have to change the original address of the example program. These shields usually control servos with a microcontroller's output pin that on Arduino Uno is the pin number 10. That's the reason why we in our previous example chose the GPIO 10 pin for our servo. But if we want to try this Waymo's D1R2, we must notice that at that place of the development board there is the GPIO pin number 15. So, if we want to use the servo connection with a Waymo's, we can do it by making this one change to the example program. Here we have a Waymo's development board and a program that controls a stepper motor and a DC motor. The motor shield is still at its default address 60. If I connect these two pads, the address of our motor shield changes from 60 to 61. And the motors start to do those some other things that the program assigns to the new address 61. This particular program was an example program and you can find it by choosing File, Examples, Adafruit Motorshield V2 Library, Stacking Test. And of course, this is an example program that is meant for controlling two motor shields that are located at two different addresses at 60 and 61. Let's try that with an ESP01 module. Here we have a program that, among other things, blinks the blue onboard LED of an ESP01 module. Over the I2C bus and through the output pin number 15 of the PCA's 9685 chip, the program also controls this red LED. The program also controls this servo motor that is at the output pin number 0 of our PCA9685 chip. As the servo shaft moves back and forth, we see that we can switch on and off mains current of an extension cord in a relatively safe way. And a very good idea is not to use those poor ESP01 modules at all. These ESP12 modules are much more reliable and versatile. Here I have one rechargeable lithium iron phosphate battery, an ESP12 module without its metal cover, a blink program, 4 jumper wires, our motor shield, and 1 red LED. If we replace those 4 jumper wires with this practical adapter plate, we have exactly the same connections, but we get a much more reliable system. You don't need many connections to run a program that is already written to a flash memory of an ESP8266 module. You can still program these flash memory chips of your end products that use ESP8266 microcontrollers if you just pull down to the ground the chip hold power down pin, and if you use as a programmer some other ESP8266 microcontroller that hasn't got a flash memory of its own. Let's upload the one last program. You can use small rechargeable batteries for your ESP8266 microcontrollers, but for your motors, remember to use separate and strong enough power sources. Thank you for this evening. There is still something that needs to be told, so stay in touch. Goodbye.